Christ, Brother Lay, you preach before I know he wipes his face with you.
Okay, keep it cool.
It's anointing.
Yeah.
It's the Lord. Come on up. We're going to do another song for you. We learned this song this year at Children's Camp in Wisconsin, and we want to share it with you. Come on up. And I'm going to stand behind Faith. Oh, I'm going to turn this on right here because I was jumping with it and it fell off. And I said, I just didn't want to lie right before I preached. That's bad. That's bad.
Yes. Yes. Testing. Our still works. But praise the Lord, everyone.
Praise the Lord.
Okay, we're going to do a song. So everybody, stand up. No, I'm just joking. Go ahead and sit back down. Okay, no, you, some of you got it. Come on, you can stand up. Come on, stand up. High fives. Oh, can we do high fives?
Yeah.
Let's do boot, butt, face. Ooh. Oh, yeah. Ooh. Okay, here we go. All right. Go ahead. Go ahead. Okay. So, this is going to be Tell the World, okay? So, I totally don't know these signs, so I'm going to run right with you guys, but maybe. Go ahead, sister, brother.
Thank you.
got spiritual. So, oh, let's see what we got. Everybody say hi to Eddie.
Hi, Eddie.
This is Eddie the Yeti.
Eddie the Yeti, can you please get out of here?
You don't like Eddie, he's already listening. Eddie the Yeti has a serious problem. Oh, he's so scared. Well, that's what we're going to talk about today.
Yeah.
Eddie was thinking he was going to be at another church today. And I didn't, you know, he thought he was going to be at our church. And so when I took him out, he was like, who are all these people? Does anybody ever get anxious around new people?
Yes.
Yes, right? Anybody ever get worried or afraid? Sometimes what happens is he feels like he gets bullied. Does anybody ever get bullied?
Yeah.
No?
I have.
You have?
Well, I
have. Eddie wants to give you a hug. Aww. So, Eddie the Yeti. Eddie was listening to me prepare my sermon yesterday, and he said what he wants is he would like me. No.
What did he say?
You want me to tell a story?
No. Yes.
He wants me to tell a story. Do you guys like stories?
Yeah.
Do you like stories?
Yeah.
Do you like stories?
Well,
do you like stories? Okay, so Eddie's like, oh, you can't take it? Eddie can't take the stress right now, so we're going to put Eddie up real quick. But he may come back later. I do want to tell you guys a story today, and I want to speak to you about something that the Lord has put on my heart, and it is about fear.
It is a large balloon.
It is a large balloon. Could you hold this for me? Does anybody know how to tie a balloon?
girl some food. She wanted all that pie, and she's talking about hot dogs.
I like your hearts. I like it. Go ahead, count it up.
I
want
to do
it. Okay. You know what this is? Anyone know what this is? Take a guess. Anyone know what this is?
A rat.
Good choice, but no. A bird, baby.
Crocodile.
Okay. Who knows what a panic attack is? Huh? You do?
Yeah,
a
panic
attack. Ah! Show me what a panic is. I got any adults who have ever been in a panic? Anybody, any adults want to show what a panic is? How about any moms? Sister Holland? Can I read you guys a story out of the Bible?
Yes!
Okay, first I want to ask you one question. okay? And you gotta raise your hand. You can't just blurt this one out. Because this bee's going home with somebody today. It's going home with somebody. All right? It is. It may be me. I'm just joking. But this bee's going home with someone. But I want to read you a story first. But first I want to ask a very important question. But you got to raise your hand. How many people have started addition in school? How many people have done addition in school? Okay, addition. What's 5 plus 2?
Sometimes at the doctors we go and get a test, right?
So he goes, he says, for it already, he already had in his mind what he was going to do. But Philip answered him and said, it would take a half a year's wage, one half year's wage, to feed all these people. So let's say you make $100,000. It would take $50,000. $50,000. Right? Wait, come on. Can we feed 5,000 people on $50,000? Okay, yeah, we probably could if they're eating small. You know? But so then what happens is it would take half a year's wage. So Simon Peter's brother spoke up and said, here's a boy with five small barley loaves and two small fishes. But how far will they go among so many? And Jesus said, have the people sit down. You guys can sit down. Oh, you already sat down. Okay, Jesus said, have the people sit down. There was plenty of grass in that place, and they sat down. We're not sitting on grass today. And there was about 5,000 men were there. 5,000. And Jesus then took the loaves and gave thanks and distributed it to those who were seated as much as they wanted. And he did the same with the fish. And when they had all had enough to eat, he said to his disciples, gather the pieces that are left over. Let nothing be wasted. So they gathered them and filled 12 baskets with pieces of the five barley loaves and left over by those who had eaten. So today I want to talk to you guys, and not just the kids. I want to be real quick, and I'm not going to keep you guys for much longer. You guys give me 15 minutes? 15 solid minutes from right now to then, and I want to preach to you, and I want to talk to you about faith over fear. I want to talk to you about the spirit of fear that is not only vexing the United States of America, but that is prevalent in the church, and that is going straight through the church. And I want to talk to you right now about that you feel like your situation is out of control and that you can't do anything to touch that situation. That's what I want to talk about. Let's pray right now. In the name of Jesus, we ask you, God. God, I feel your spirit in this place. I feel the Holy Ghost of power coming and moving in this place. I ask you right now in the precious name of Jesus, Lord. Lord, you do a work. Lord, don't let me come with my enticing words of man's wisdom, but Lord, you come with the power and demonstration of the Holy Ghost, Lord Jesus. You do the work, Jesus. I pray in your precious name, let your word do the work in Jesus' name. So what I want to talk to you today is about four simple things. One, God knows what you need before you even ask. The Bible said right there in that chapter, when Jesus looked and saw a great crowd coming towards him, he said, Philip, where shall we buy bread for these people to eat? Understand, they were following Jesus in the wilderness, right? They were following Jesus out in the wilderness. There was no McDonald's. There was no Chick-fil-A. There was no Taco Bell. Can I get an amen?
Amen.
All right. There was no Taco Bell. There was nothing like that. And they were following, and they said, Jesus saw them coming and said, hey, they're going to have an eat. I want you to know, I don't know where you are in life. I don't know what is going on with you. I haven't talked to your pastor about anything, but I'm telling you right now, Jesus knows your need. Right now, right today, Jesus knows your need. Right. And he has the power and the availability. And not only does he have the power, and not only does he have the availability, but he has the want to, before you even ask, to take care of your situation and help you be who you need to be. The second, sometimes God is testing you. I hate tests, Pastor. I hate tests. When I am the worst test taker, I'll study all night long, take a test, get like a 30%. It's just who I am. It's just who I am. I'm like, I get anxiety when I walk up to the test. I am what they call a test anxiety person. Does anybody, you guys know what anxiety means? So, I'm going to explain. Oh, here you are. this was a real bee, and it was coming there, and it was coming all around you, and he was going to sting you, and what would you do?
Scream.
That's anxiety.
I'd run.
Right? You're worried about something happening that may never happen. You're worried about something bad happen that may never happen. That's anxiety. Well, sometimes God is testing you to see where your faith is. Sometimes God is trying to see where you are in life. Because a lot of times we think that we're here. So when I study sometimes, I'm like, let me study for this math test. Oh, I know algebra. But then when I take it and I get a 30%, I'm like, I don't know algebra. So I see where I'm really at in life. And that's why God puts tests on us. But I'm here to tell you right now, and I feel this so strongly in my heart. I'm speaking to someone. I'm telling you right now, just because you're in that moment and you feel like you're all alone, I promise you Jesus Christ is with you.
Yeah.
I promise you, no matter what you feel like right now, God is with you. He has never seen his children. He has never seen his seed forsaken or his children begging bread. That is the scripture that is written in his word.
Amen.
The third thing, God can provide what you have. God can provide with what you have on him. Listen, I'm preaching to myself right now. Stop trying to figure it out. You stop trying to figure it out. The reason he's testing you is because he wants to say, hey, if I'm going to take you here, you need to be to rely on me.
Sure.
God is trying to say, listen, you cannot do this with your, you can't do it with what you have. You're right. When you look at the situation, 5 plus 7, 5 plus 2 equals 7, right?
Yeah.
But you know why? That's because you're doing natural math.
Oh, here.
You're doing natural math, and in natural math, 5 plus 2 equals 7. But in God's math, 5 plus 2 equals whatever he needs it to be.
Yeah.
See, there's a dimension that we have to get into. You guys know what a dimension is?
No.
I don't know how to explain it, but I'm going to get into it. Okay, there's a dimension. Do you guys believe in angels? I do. Can you see the angels right now?
No.
But they're there, right? That's another dimension. I just did a pretty good job. Thank you very much. Right? Right? So what am I saying? There's a dimension that you can't see and you can't understand. But what's happening is your heart is overwhelmed. And the Bible says, when my heart is overwhelmed, lead me to the rock that is higher than I. Something that I can stand on that will not move. Something that I can be on that will not go anywhere. It will not shake. It will not move. And that's what I'm trying to speak to you about right now. What I'm trying to tell you is God sees your situation. God sees your problem. God knows your issue. And he's telling you 5 plus 2 doesn't equal 7. Because you're trying to figure it out up here and you're like, God, I can't see a way of escape out of this situation. Lord, I don't know what's going to happen in this situation. But God's saying, couldn't you just trust me? Couldn't you just trust me? The Lord, and I'm here, they never even asked. They never even asked to be fed, as far as we know. I'm sure there were some of them people, you know. How many? Come on, sister. Right? How many ever took a car trip? I know you have a sister, huh? You get in there with those kids, taking them to Bible quizzing, 20 minutes on the road. Mom! When are we going to stop and eat? I'm super hungry. I don't know why I just went to a Brooklyn accent. I'd like a pizza pie, please. Okay, but we get hungry, and so the Lord knows before you even ask. The Lord knows your situation before you even ask. And the Lord's trying to speed me up because he took me all the way to the last page. The last thing is, us to bet everybody. The Bible says until they were full. You're worried about God meeting your smallest need, and God sitting here saying, I want to give you more than you've ever had in life.
Yeah.
Now, I will tell you, I am not the preacher who is like naming and claiming. That's not what I'm here to do. I'm not that preacher. I am preaching to myself right now. We've had some hard years, right? Especially living here in Jersey. It's been hard, right? There's been times we can't get together. There's been times that the world would like to separate us from the body. God has you right where He wants you. See, the Spirit of God is what is going to move in your life. The first thing we need is the Holy Ghost. The Bible says, because remember, we're talking about faith over fear. But you, dear friend, by building yourself up in your most holy faith and praying in the Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit is the Holy Ghost. That Holy Ghost, if you need faith to make it through your situation, you need to start praying in the Holy Ghost. You said, well, preacher, it's been months since I spoke in tongues. Today's the day.
Yeah.
Right. Today's the day before you walk out. You said, Brother Mike, I've never received the gift of the Holy Ghost. Today's the day.
Yeah.
Today's the day that you can receive the gift of the Holy Ghost. Today's the day that you can be refilled. You want faith? That's what the Bible says. Building yourself up in your most holy faith and pray in the Holy Ghost. It also talks about we need each other to build. In Hebrews 11, chapter 6, it says, without faith it is impossible to please Him. For he who comes to God must believe that He is, and that He is a rewarder of those who diligently seek Him. God wants you to seek Him. Today's that day. I don't know what your situation is. I prayed for this service for about a month and a half. And never in my life have I felt such a burden. Never in my life. And maybe it's just for me. I'll give you that. But never in my life have I felt such a burden of anxiety and fear. I have no idea what it's about. I have no idea. I'm not usually the worrying type. I really am not. I'm like, Lord, I can make it through. Jesus, help me today. I'll make it through. I'll do whatever. But I'm telling you right now, there is a spirit of fear that is vexing our church. Yeah. And not just the church in Wrightstown, not just the church in Milford, not just the church in Newark, not just the church in Pennsville. But there is a spirit of anxiety, a spirit of fear. And the Bible says, take no thought for tomorrow, because tomorrow will take care of itself.
Yeah.
I want to wrap up here. Indeed, in John chapter 16, it says, and indeed the hour is coming. Yes, has now come that you will be scattered. Each of his own will leave me alone, and yet I am not alone because the Father is with me. These things have I spoken to you, that in me you may have peace. In the world you will have tribulation, but be of good cheer. I have overcome the world. John chapter 1, verse 4 and 4 says, You are God's little children, and you have overcome them, because he who is in you is greater than he that is in the world. Go ahead and say it right now. He that is in me,
is greater than he that is in the world.
Who's inside of you?
Jesus.
Who's in you?
Jesus.
Who's in you?
Jesus.
I know this is a children's service, but I'm talking to adults too. Come on, adults. Who's inside of you right now?
Jesus.
Who dwells inside of you? Who dwells inside of you? Who moves inside of you? Who is the person who's helping you? Who's helping you make it through day to day? It's Jesus. If then we are raised with Christ, this is Colossians 3 and 3. If we then are raised with Christ, seek those things which are above, where Christ is sitting at the right hand. set your mind on things above, not on the things of this earth. For you died, and your life is hidden with Christ in God. When Christ, who is our life, appears, then you will also appear with him in glory. I just want to skip down to one thing, verse 10 of Colossians 3, and it says, and have put on the new man, who is renewed in knowledge according to the image of him who created him. Where there is neither Greek, nor Jew, nor circumcised, nor uncircumcised, nor barbarian, nor Scythian, nor slave, nor free, but Christ is all and in all in you. I'm going to the end, and he says in Revelation 21, and it says, and he said to me, it is done. I am the Alpha and the Omega. I am the beginning and the end. I will give of the fountain of the water of life freely to him who thirsts. He who overcomes shall inherit all things, and I will be his God, and he shall be my son.
What?
You just multiply. You start leaving them together before you know it. Yo, if I left them in there, I'd have 15, 16 bees, right? So I got these cool bees. And one bee's not bad, right? One bee you can swat away. But the Bible says in that one scripture, if we could leave that up there, thank you, he said, but he is, and he said to me, it is done, I am the Alpha and the Omega. Who knows what Alpha and Omega means? Yeah. It's like a ruler. Okay, yeah. Well, yeah, you can say it's a ruler. So he's the Alpha and the Omega. He's the front of the ruler, and he's the back of the ruler. He's the beginning and the end. Everything starts with him. Everything finishes with him. The beginning and the end. I will give you the fountain of water of life freely to him who thirsts. My sister right here was asking for a drink earlier, weren't you? You said you were thirsty? What? Right? Who wants a drink?
Me.
Right? Well, you're going to get a chance right now. I think we're talking about a different type of water, but that's okay. But who wants a drink? See, we're trying to overcome fear. We're trying to overcome this world by what we have, what our resources can do. But God is saying, I've come to give you what you need, and that's the Holy Ghost. I've come to give you the fountain of water of life freely to him who thirsts. He who overcomes shall inherit all things. Why do you think, right here at the end of the Bible, at the end of what some of the last writings, well, I think God purposely put that there, that the fountain of water would come right before he who overcomes. Because you can't overcome without the Holy Ghost.
That's
Amen.
You need the Holy Ghost. I need the Holy Ghost. And we can't do it without the Holy Ghost. I wonder if we could all stand. And I'm going to put these guys up right here for right now. And I'm going to trap them in here so they can't get out. Because they like to fly around. It's crazy. You think I'm doing it? It could be. It could be. But today, I wonder. You know what? Maybe the Lord was just talking to myself about fear and anxiety for the past 2 months. Maybe the Lord was just moving upon me. I know that's not the case. I know there's people in here right now. I know there's people that, I know that there are souls in here right now who are hurting and are struggling each and every day and don't know how to turn or don't know what the answer is. everybody says, but I promise you that He is the answer. We're going to open up these altars. We can play some music in the background. We can do whatever it is that you guys normally do. This altar's open. The Bible says that, behold, I stand at the door. And if any man should knock, I will hear him and I will come home and let him in. I don't know what your situation is. I don't know where you're at. But I know that God wants to touch you. I know that the fear that you go, the fear that keeps you up and wakes you up in the middle of the night, that fear that tosses and turns, that is not what God has called for you to live. That is not where God has called for you to be. God wants you to live a life that is hopeful. I talked to a lady in Sherwin-Williams. I work as a construction person. And as I'm talking to Jamie, is her name, she starts to cry. She's the manager of the Sherwin-Williams, and her eyes get teared up, and she starts to cry. And I said, what's wrong with Jamie? And she goes, you know, there's no hope. And I start quoting scripture to her, and I start telling her about God. But there is hope. I'm here to tell you the same thing I told Jamie. It's the same thing. There is no hope in this world. This world is going to burn up. This world is going to be destroyed. But I'm telling you right now, there is a hope. There is a hope, and He's coming quickly, folks. I'm not trying to emotionally manipulate you, but I am trying to tell you the truth. If I had to play tug of war right now with you and the devil, I promise you I would stand there and do whatever I could to pull you in, because I'm telling you that the trumpet sound is coming so soon. And I don't know if you're ready. I don't know where you're at in life. But I know I'm preaching to someone right now. This altar is open. We're just going to start praying in the name of Jesus.